Shares. Shares.
Oh, that sounds so nice.
Shares. So what are shares and what is percentage ownership? What's the difference between these things? And how do you even determine how many shares you have? Most people, when they are creating a company, they have to actually file and say how many shares that exist. You can say you have 100 shares in your company. You can say you have 1 million shares. You could say you have 1 billion shares. But 1 billion shares in your company. But in fact, there are reasons to have a lower number of shares, like 1 million or 100,000 or 1,000. In certain states, they charge you as a filing fee with that state by the number of shares that you say you have. Other states, they charge based off of the par value per share and other sort of complications. If you're filing as a Delaware corporation, you can easily file with 1 million shares with a low par value, and that ends up being just a nice, easy way to get started, 1 million shares. It could be 10 million shares. It doesn't matter all that much. The reason why people like to have 1 million shares, for example, or 2 million shares, is because they like to have the dollar amounts that you're paying per share be, a reasonable dollar amount level. You don't want to be paying 2 cents a share because it makes your stock seem like it's pretty worthless. So you could have 1 billion shares, right, and have it be worth 2 tenths of a cent per share, and it's the same thing as having a million shares and having it be worth, is that $2 a share? I think it's worth $2 a share versus 2 tenths of a cent per share. So you would allocate the number of shares in your company, and sometimes you'll actually say there are allocated shares and issued shares. When you file with the state of Delaware, you may file that you have 5 million shares allocated and 1 million shares issued. The only number of shares that matter are the shares that are issued. And so all the percentages of the company relate to the issued shares. And the shares that you issue are sometimes issued via your stock option program. You may set aside at least 10% of your company in your stock option program, or 15% of your company in your ESOP plan. ESOP employee stock option program. And then you'll allocate the remainder of the shares to all the founders initially. And a lot of times people will talk about the percentage. So if one founder gets 300,000 shares, another founder gets 300,000 shares, a third founder gets 400,000 shares of the original 1 million shares, then there's 30-40% sort of breakdown. You add in the 15% dilution for your ESOP plan, and all of a sudden it's one founder getting 26.5%, another founder getting 26.5%, and the third founder getting 34% of the company. So that is a little bit about what number of shares, it's a bit of a discussion about the number of shares to have and to say and to issue. It doesn't matter to anyone who's really knowledgeable. Like, it doesn't matter to me as a venture capitalist whether I'm paying $200 a share or $2 a share. Obviously, the percentage matters more than anything else. But when you have staff, when you have employees, and you say, we are going to give you 2 shares, of a company, it may not be quite as moving to them as if you say, we're going to give you 2,000 shares or 20,000 shares. So sometimes for psychological purposes, it will be very common for people to have a larger number of shares that are allocated and issued. The reason to have more shares allocated in your articles of incorporation with the state of Delaware, for example, is so that you can, as a board of directors, approve to issue more shares without having to go file more paperwork with the government to get that approved and pay more fees. So you'll allocate more than you'll actually issue, and the board of directors can approve the issuance of more shares, as well as the allocation of more shares to the ESOP pool, et cetera, on a new round of financing, and with the approval of any preferred shareholders who would normally be involved in approving those new share issuances. So that's a lot of detail about the various reasons why people talk about shares and percentages of shares and the number of shares and that you may choose, which is fairly arbitrary, but there are reasons why people end up going with a couple of million shares effectively that are being allocated and issued for startups. That is shares and percentages.
VC lingo.